gonna get better. I know it will. Just hope you know I still I pray for you.
So I managed to make it to where I am delivering to, and especially for the newer drivers, I highly encourage and recommend check up on some of these facilities of where you're delivering or where you're picking up to find out whether they have truck parking or what are the restrictions when it comes to driving in certain areas that have no through trucks, because you will be surprised how many of these cities and states that you are delivering and picking up that to get there you have to go through like all types of hoops and loops to just to make it there, you know. So Google these things before you get to where you need to get to. Honestly, it'll supersede your expectations, in all honesty, because who wants to be surprised in a 53-foot trailer with a truck? You know, like, who? Nobody wants to go through that. So look out for yourself, your own interest, and you'll be fine. So I'm finna do this post-trip. I'm gonna fix me something to eat. I gotta wipe my face because I don't know why my face gets super oily after I'm done driving, brush my teeth. I'm gonna meditate. And after that, I'm gonna lay it down because I'm not supposed to get unloaded for a couple more hours. And my body is drained, okay? My body is drained.
Where it all begins in Waterloo, Iowa.
This one? Or ta-da!
Olive Garden tonight, baby. So we finna start cooking on the truck because eating out is starting to become too much.
Jehovah guide me. You know, cause we know such a list of fight me. Yeah, I go be so miraculous.
Hello to all my beautiful women and all my amazing men out there in the world. I hope y'all are looking good, doing good, and feeling fantastic. Excuse me because my energy is on 1,000 right now, all right? I'm filled with life, thankful to be alive, and we're just riding out on the late night.
For the women who want to get into trucking, make sure you thoroughly evaluate what you have going on currently before you decide to embark on this opportunity. Because what I found out that oftentimes there are certain women who get out here into this industry and they end up becoming solo drivers, and sometimes it's a challenge for them to kind of figure it out exactly, to get into the groove of it, you know, like they end up being more scared than they thought, so they end up quitting. They have a difficult time choosing the right company that's suitable for them, and it's just, I don't know. I feel like sometimes there are some people, not just women, but this part is for men and women, they end up getting led in the wrong direction because honestly, they're not looking in the right areas. So research as much as you can, and just honestly come into this with an open mind, and honestly, it may be one of your best and biggest benefits.
It'll either help us grow or it'll damage certain aspects of ourself, our lives, personal relationships, so on and so forth. So I'm just curious to know some of you all's thoughts. Do you honestly know what you're doing this for? Do you have goals aligned within like your path? Sometimes this lifestyle can be so draining because your grind can be so consistent and you know exactly what direction you're heading in. And sometimes I promise you, when you're on your grind and you feel like your work ethic is so strong, sometimes you feel like it may not be paying off the way that it should. But what do? Do you give up? No. You don't give up because at the end of the day, you have to look at the broader spectrum. You know, look at the overall picture, because your success, it takes time to succeed on whatever platform that you're on. However you want to elevate, it takes time. It's all like that whole patience is a virtue type of thing. It's patience. Patience is one of the biggest factors that
we all need when it comes to being out here. And just because you're not seeing the positive results that you truly want, don't give up on it. Don't. I promise you don't. It'll take time to receive whatever blessings that are placed forth in front of you. Trust the process, man. Trust the process. And I'm telling you, it'll happen for you in due time, when it's the right time. So I'm gonna let y'all in on something. Upon entering these cities, man, upon entering these cities with these narrow, tight roads, my stomach get the twisting, my eye get the twitching, my hand get the shaking, the sweat start to drip. Man, I don't know what goes on in my mind, but it's always that you don't know what to expect, so just proceed with caution, you know? And I'm extremely conscientious of the things that's going on throughout the nighttime versus the daytime, because for some odd reason, my mind and my, like, I'm just more alert. I don't get it. I don't understand it. I'm just more alert throughout the nighttime. But as soon as the daylight hit, it just all hell broke loose. I don't understand, like, why it is the way it is, but I sleep a little bit better in the day, okay? I'm just super hyped throughout the night, and now I'm about to turn into this area that I've never been before when it comes to picking up this 4 Loko load. And this appointment was originally scheduled for 10 p.m., but I was on my 34-hour reset, and the reset did not end until 8:18 p.m., so as soon as it was over, I hightailed down there. And I got there around 11:25 p.m. And thankfully, these individuals are 24 hours and they took me in. Straight like that. For my newer drivers and my older drivers, y'all know the joy of backing up off the street? It ain't no joy. It's really not, like, for real. But it ain't too bad because it's super late and I'm the only one here. So that's a big benefit, right?
I've been on my hustle. It ain't too many people I look up to. I've been grinding.
So I don't know what type of superpowers this man had, but I promise you, this load was 43,000 pounds worth of 4 Lokos. It hasn't been more than an hour yet. And I was really trying to sleep, but I heard someone knocking on the door and I was like, Lord, please give me 30 more minutes.
Hey, y'all. So this man, he was extremely polite and everything, but he started to hit on me and it started to make me feel extra awkward and uncomfortable because he was as old as my dad. And I'm like, ugh. But I'll just show y'all the clip.
Yeah, tell you what.
You don't mind. Creeps on you. It creeps up on you.
You don't mind having a rider with you? I'll come and ride with you.
I actually like the piece.
And you're even unlocked. I'm a CDL driver.
Yeah, that's what's up.
As y'all can see, it ain't nobody but me. No, but these be some of the best nights, the best times to drive. No lie. No lie. Woo! Lord, it's time. I think about maybe within 2 hours, maybe 3 hours, I'll stop, get a shower in, you know, grab something to eat. But almonds will help you throughout the night. Sugar-free gum may help you throughout the night. Some beef jerky if it's not too salty for you. Some people say they like sunflower seeds. I think sunflower seeds keep you alert like a mug. What else? Coffee, if you're big on coffee. Stuff like that runs through me. Caffeine is not good for my face. I try to stay away from it. But if I need it, that drink right there that's posted up, yes sir, that's what I will literally swear by.
So let's get a little personal, you know, up close and personal. Because to be honest, some of y'all don't even make it to this part of the video. Throughout this duration,
this load is heavy. It's even pulling heavy.
Do I get lonely over the road? Hell yeah, I do. You know, it'd be certain nights. It's when you cruising through the late nights. You may wonder, you know, contemplate on whether you truly want somebody there. You know, rub up on you a little bit. I don't know, like someone to, I don't know, you like mesmerized by someone else's mind. Or you could just be riding out with somebody and y'all don't talk. Y'all just within each other's presence, riding out. Of course, it will depend on many factors, on how the other person is driving, on how comfortable you will be riding out. Sometimes you just may want to lay up next to somebody. You know, y'all don't really have to converse, but that's how it be sometimes. Whenever like you're intertwined with someone else's mind, y'all just have some type of clear, keen understanding of each other. Do I get lonely? As I said, yes. But can I like resist certain things? Absolutely. Because my focus is so strong and I don't really worry about the unnecessary. I do not apply pressure where pressure isn't due. You know, I don't bring attention towards me that isn't needed. So I know how to block certain things out mentally because that's just me. That's what I do. I'm great at it, honestly. And I promise you, driving is a part of me so much to where I don't even treat this job as a job. You know, I don't treat what I do just, oh, this is just my job. Like, this is really something I enjoy doing. I enjoy driving, but it's more to it than just driving. Yeah, man.
So this is going to be the first fuel stop of this trip. You know, it'd be a great time to warm up my food. I would shower now, but baby, we trying to make it through Chicago before the wrong time hits.
Okay, so as we filling up, this time I utilize to check my tires, especially on these late nights, you know, in between filling up, because you never know what to expect. You fill up and then like dang near 50 miles down the road, you driving the whole flat. And then on top of that, the flat was there as you were filling up, but you just didn't peep it. And I got time for that. So I honestly am extra meticulous. Dang, you got on my boots.
Oh my.
And this came out. Y'all see that? Mm-hmm. I wouldn't have known. Because I promise I checked it. Lord have mercy. Am I even doing this right? Because I checked this when I left. And it seemed okay. Honestly. The dang thing near loose. Now see, if I didn't check this, I wouldn't have known. Lord, let this be a-okay. Thank God for midway trips, I'll tell you that. Make sure to get straight. Thank God for trips. This tire is bad because the outside tread is wearing out, was wearing down more than these. So this tire is gonna have to get changed real soon. Yo, I'm really tight because I promise you, when I left my pickup in Wisconsin, I definitely, it must have came loose when I was driving. Oh, thank God. So yeah, once I'm done checking my tires, checking the lights, make sure everything's right and intact, I'm gonna warm up my food and get on down the road, because bruh, ain't nobody trying to hit no type of traffic when it comes to being in Chicago.
Keep a sharp observation, allowing no infiltration of those you let in your circle. They get the chance, they gon' hurt you. They be counting you.
All this traffic. Right now, it's clear on this side, but it's this is what I was needing to avoid when I was coming from Wisconsin. This. For real. And it's only 6 o'clock in the morning. Only. Oh.
So out of all the many spots I could have chose, I chose to park back here. And something I found very interesting, after I parked on this morning, normally I sleep in. After I'm done showering and doing the things I need to do, I will sleep in to like about 12 something if I go to sleep around 6 or 7. But I woke up and the first thing I checked was the time, and it said 2:08 p.m. I was so proud of myself. So proud.
So this is my lunch. I really am considering becoming a seafood eater, but right now this is.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you? These halls be so tight. But something I found interesting is this guy gave me this. So if anyone's an owner operator looking for a job, yeah, he gave me that. Operator, this may be something to look into, I don't know.
So this video was intended to be like this, a riding out vlog, you know, rambling through random thoughts. And I truly find it easier for me because I don't allow what I do to affect me, you know. I don't allow this profession to intimidate me or discourage me in any form or fashion. I enjoy driving, and for some people, legit, driving is therapeutic for them. So that's why it makes it a lot easier to where they don't look at it as this is just a job.
You gotta get in where you fit in, for real. So I finally made it to where I'm supposed to deliver to, and I promise you, what will save you the most when it comes to some of these facilities is checking the locations online before you get there. Because this area, I promise you, it's like no truck signs, like everywhere. You know, when in terms of like upon entering this facility. So your best bet is to find out the exact location where the trucks are allowed around the areas, so on and so forth. Because man, this, it'd be too much. This be too much.
Do what you love what you do, at most let it work best for you. Don't allow anybody to discourage you, because that's hella whack. Y'all stay safe out in these streets. Facilities that have all the space in the world end up being the ones that want you to leave the lot as soon as you're done. Yes, it be like that at some places.
You can't walk inside my shoes like a sneaker punk. I overcome obstacles and they still come. I was trying to make a way.